सूत्र 59, ओ रामांतानाम अनंतानाम चाव्ययानाम सर्वेश्वरे अव्ययस अव्ययस आर द इनडिक्लाइनेबल वर्ड्स. ओके, आई विल एक्सप्लेन दैट इवन. So अव्ययस लिटरली न व्यय इति. व्यय मीन्स लाइक समथिंग विच इज लायबल टू चेंज, यू नो, वेन देर इज सम लाइक चेंज, सो दैट्स व्यय. But avyaya means something which is unchangeable. So the words which are unchangeable, the Sanskrit words, are called avyayas. For example, let's say cha. We have seen this cha a lot. You will never see it like cham or chaha and so on. It will always be cha wherever you see it, right? Then words like iti, words like api,
वही
वही,
वही तू तू
तू, ह, so many of them. So all these words are अव्ययस because they
ठीक.
never change in their form. They always remain as they are. So the sutra says अव्ययस that end in ओ राम. So now there is a group of अव्ययस words which end in O Rama. So here are they. So atho, aho, aho, utaho, o, no, bho, hung ho, and ho. So all these are the avyayas. And avyayas do have meaning. It's not that they do not have any meaning. They have meaning. And they are ending with O Rama. So something wrong with the PDF here. Okay. So the sutra says that avyayas that end in O Rama, number one, or avyayas which are anantas. What is ananta?
आ ई ऊ अनंता.
Right. A e u ananta. So the six of them, they are called anantas. So we have. So one is like we know these Sarveshwaras, a, e, u, and Trivikrama. So we know them as like individual Varnas as Sarveshwaras, but they are also avyayas, like separately being individual Varnas letters, Sarveshwaras. That's one thing, but they are also avyayas and they also have some specific particular meanings. Let's read them and it's very interesting. So Jiva Goswami explains that the kevala anantas means only anantas, like only a rama, only a rama, only e, and so on, headed by a rama, are used in the sense of addressing is like sambodhana, calling someone out, and so forth. For example, the avyaya a is used in the sense of addressing sambodhana. So the avyaya a is used in the sense of addressing sambodhana. For example, a ananta. So here a acts like hey, or you know, hey ananta in English, o ananta. So that's the prayoga of this ananta, which is avyaya here, a ananta. You might be thinking then why we have not done sandhi here, so why it's not ananta. So this is because of this current rule. So we'll come back to the current rule. Let's read the ananta avyayas and their meanings. Then Trivikrama a is used in the sense of remembrance, smarana. For example, आ एवं अच्युत लीला, आ Achyuta's pastime is in this way. So a remembrance, smarana. Then the varna e, the ananta avyaya e, vamana e, is used in the sense of reproach, bhartsana, like ninda or dhikkar. So what example is like e, achyutam na bhajasi, shame on you, you don't worship achyuta. The e, like in Hindi also we have such ananta ways like chi, you know, to express like how to say
disgust,
right? We say chi. E when it's like painting e. So similarly in Sanskrit also we have such stuff. Nantrivikrama e is used in the sense of filling up a sentence, vakpurana, sometimes while composing a shloka, when we don't get any word and there is a place for one syllable or two syllables left out, then we add some avyaya as vakpurana. So for example, e, idrishah sansarah. So well, the material world is like this. So vakpurana. Then vamana u is used in the sense of humble entreaty, amantrana, like, so u achyuta, please come, o achyuta, so amantrana. And then the trivikrama u is used in the sense of pratishedha, prohibition. So trivikrama u, upasannam mam tyajasi, don't abandon me who have come near. So this u acts like na, or you know, a prohibition. So like that, all of these anantas are here avyaya anantas or ananta avyayas, which have these specific meanings. And then we also studied the avyayas which end in O Rama. Yes, Prabhuji.
So Prabhuji, in the Dirgha or Trivikram U usage here, where you said it is used for prohibition or pratishedha. So my question is, there the word used was tyajasi. So wouldn't ajnartha be used when the context is don't, in the sense that, so you said the Trivikram U is used in the place of Narama, right?
No. Not literally, but that sense is there in the meaning of U.
So then shouldn't it be upasannam mam tyaja? Why tyajasi present tense is used? Shouldn't it be ajnartha, like kuru or whatever, like?
Means Jiva Goswami gives this example, pratishedhe u upasannam mam tyajasi. So the example is given by Jiva Goswami himself, tyajasi. And it is like, you know, translating into English, sometimes it's not completely equivalent to the Sanskrit term. So,
okay.
Yeah. So, but the example is tyajasi by Jiva Goswami.
So can we take it like you shouldn't be rejecting me?
Yes, I would go for that. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And on top of that, obviously tyajasi is like achyuta, which means the present tense pratyaya. But achyuta adayaha, what is that? Vartaman adayo, right? Yes. So apart from indicating the present tense, these pratyas also indicate a lot of many other things, situations, context, and so on. So that's the whole study of karma.
Okay. Yeah. Sure.
So yes. So if we are here, Thank you. So the Sutra 57. Explains that if we have avyayas ending with O Rama or Kevala, Ananta avyayas, like we studied in different meanings, and then Sarveshvara following. Sarvesh, then there will be no sandhi. There will be no sandhi. So avyayas that end in orama or that are anantas do not undergo sandhi when a sarveshvara follows. So there won't be any sandhi in such case. So for example, no yukta upendraha. So ideally we could have applied o av. I think Sutra 53 or 54. Yeah, no, the O could have turned into of because the Sarveshwara is following, but because this no is an avyaya which ends with O Rama, so we do not do any sandhi here on the basis of this current Sutra. O Rama antanam anantanam chavyayanam Sarveshwari. So it's just no Upendraha. Similarly, no yukta achyutah remains no achyutah ityadi. Similarly, with ananta avyayas, a yukta ananta, we do not do any sandhi. Same rule, same sutra. A yukta evam achyuta lila, so we don't apply edvay ai, and we don't turn it into aivam. So it's a evam ityadi. Same everywhere. So this sutra is a Pratishedha sutra. Pratishedha sutra, a prohibition, a prohibitive rule. It is restricting the application of a certain rule or of a certain operation. Okay. How do you know which words are avyaya? So we have a complete list of avyayas with their meanings. So if you are interested, generally I share that in the third chapter. No, in the second chapter actually, when we study nouns. But if you want, we can share it. And also you can look up to dictionaries. For example, if I search for cha, then yeah, it will say here this IND, which means indeclinable. So in dictionaries also you will get to see it. Then the last sutra for Sarveshvara Sandhi is E du de tam dvivachanasya mani vadi varjam. That and Trivikrama E, Trivikrama U, or again, A is also Trivikrama, that belongs to Dvivachana, does not undergo sandhi when a Sarveshvara follows. So for example, Sutra 58 is saying that if we have words which are Dvivachana, so we know Dvivachana, dual case, so which are in Dvivachana, and ending with Trivikrama E or Trivikrama U or A, and any Sarveshvara following, then again no sandhi. So now the question will be, how will we identify which one is dual case or not? So that we actually learn in the second chapter. But for the timing, we just know the concept, the rule. So we don't do any sandhi. For example, Jiva Goswami gives examples like Hari Yukta Atra. So this Hari is dual case form. Hari Harayaha Ityadi. We'll learn that in the second chapter. So, because this is Trivikrama E, and this word is in dual case, and a Sarveshwara following. So generally, we could have applied Indvayam Eva Yaha Sarveshwara, and E turning into Ya Rama. But because of this, again, a Pratishedha rule, prohibitive rule, there is no Sandhi. So they remain as they are. Same here, Vishnu Yukta Atra. Vishnu is dual, ending with Trivikrama U. So no Sandhi. Same here with Amu Atra. Gange Yukta Atra, same, E Rama. And Bhajete Yukta Ajitam. So no Sandhi. But the Manivadis are an exception to this rule. This rule is an exception to the previous rules where Sandhis were done. And now we have exception to the exception. So the Manivadis are an exception to the exception to this rule. So Manivadis are a group of words like Mani Yukta Iva. So although this Mani is ending with Trivikrama E and is in dual case, but we still do Sandhi here because it is an exception to this rule. So Mani Iva, Dashavatarekatmake Melitva Trivikrama, we apply. Similarly, Dampati Yukta Iva, Rodasi Yukta Iva, Janpati Yukta Iva. So the full group of Manivadis, it's given here in Amrita. So here we'll do Sandhi, although these words are in dual case. Yes. So here we complete the Sarveshwara Sandhi. Yes. So any questions here, any discussion? Anything you want to share from your homework, Sandhis you have found, or... Yes, anything related to Sandhis?
Prabhu.
Yes, Hare
Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
I have no tutelage in dual case. Is there a place where I can get like very simple preliminary discussion of cases?
Yes.
I don't know if I need that, but I understand what you said about dual case, but I don't know how much more I need to know.
Means it's depends on you. If you want to read, I can provide a PDF, a small PDF about cases. You can read it.
Okay. Thank you.
So I'll share it in the group.
Do you think I need to? I mean, would it help me?
Yes. Why not?
Okay. It could confuse me too. I don't think so, but...
Means till the time we are not overburdened, and it's okay. Anything else with the Sarveshwara Sandhis? So Vishnu Jana Sandhi will be like level 2. Okay, I'll try to give some Sandhis here. Let's check if, like a quick surprise test or something, you can say, assessment. Let me try to take out my book. So meanwhile, I'm giving 2 minutes. You can just like go through all the Sarveshwara Sandhi rules. And then I'll just start giving some Sandhis here, which you will have to do. So yeah, take 2 minutes just to look over the rules, the sutras, the examples. Okay, let's do this as Sandhi. I didn't want to write this for Sandhi, but we can make a Sandhi out of it. I have opened 3 books to get good sandhis. Wow. Upadesh, Upadesha, Krishna, Upadesha. So in sandhis like this, in the like the seventh one, we have to like undo the sandhi and write the 2 words, or could be more words even. गिरिराज प्रभु, आपने पहले का देख लिया, सब वीडियोस वगैरह सुन लिया था?
Yes, Roji. Not all. Four classes I heard, Roji.
Okay.
Till up to I think 35-40 sutras.
Oh, we are supposed to write it separately, or we will go through this in the class now?
We'll go through this in the class also.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you are working on your like computer, if you're writing it down, so you can also like copy paste like this and this from Google Doc. You will have the link. Yeah. You can, and then write the answers.
So, Prabhuji, are we supposed to submit this or something, or just for our reference?
No, it's just like classwork. You don't need to submit it.
Okay. Okay.
So we'll just discuss this in the class.
Okay.
This last one. Okay, 25. Okay.
Could you send the link for this Google Doc in the chat, if possible?
I sent it.
Yeah, would you mind? Thank you.
Where is it?
On the top.
Yeah, it's on the top.
Oh. And then we'll discuss it. Okay, is everyone done? So let's solve all these Sundays.
Yes, Professor.
Okay, so the first one, I'll do the Sandhi and I'll also say the Sutra so you can relate to it. And yeah, so Sandhi Yukta Abhyasa, so, so Sandhya Abhyasa. इद्वयमेव यः सर्वेश्वरे क्षितियुक्त ईशः बिकम्स क्षितीशः दशावतारकात्मके मिलित्वा त्रिविक्रमः पितृयुक्त अर्णव
प्रोजी शुडंट इन द फर्स्ट द गैप शुड बी रिमूव्ड राइट इट विल बी वन वर्ड राइट प्रोजी वंस
मींस आइडियली इट इज समास सो हाइफन
ओके
पितृयुक्त अर्णव सो ऋद्वम रह सो ऋद्वम रह एंड वी गेट पितृर्णव वी कैन अगेन पुट हाइफन डोंट वरी अबाउट दिस हाइफन वी शुड पुट और नॉट Just don't put it for the timing. In Samasa, we'll actually learn how to put hyphens. I mean, basically, the different words of a compound. So, Tathayukta iti.
Tatheti.
Tatheti. Advamidvaye.
It's 9 o'clock.
No, it's 10:30 here. गुरु उपदेशः
उद्वयमः
नो दशावतारकात्मके
दशावतारे
सॉरी दशावतारे गुरु उपदेश
गुरु उपदेशः सो दशावतारकात्मके मिलित्वा त्रिविक्रमः अद्ययुक्त एव
एद्वयै
अद्ययैव Devaishwaryam. So two words are
Deva Aishwaryam.
So Edvai. Ganga Yukta Udakam.
Udvayo. Gangodakam.
Udvayo. So Gangodakam. Saptarshinam.
Hridaye Ay.
Saptarshinam.
Rishinam. Iti yukta aha.
Idvayameva yaha
sarveshwari. So, ityaha. Matri yukta anumati.
Idvayam raha.
Matra anumati.
So, matra anumati. Shishu yukta aikyam.
Udvayam yaha.
Udvam raha. So, Shishvaikyam, Nadi Yukta Udakam,
Idvayameva Yaha,
Nadi Udakam, नदी युक्त इति ऋतौ युक्त अन्नम लोको अयम
लोकोयमस्ते
So, लोकोयम लोकोयम कर्म बंधन भगवद गीता उस श्रीयै उत्सुकः
आय आय
आय आय
श्रीयै उत्सुकः एंड
अयादिनाम
योगयोर्वा सो श्रीया उत्सुकः ओके व्हाई डोंट वी अप्लाई उद्वयम ओ है अन्येषु अधर्मेषु
उद्वयं वः
सो अन्येष्व धर्मेषु चैकम् एकम् अनेको असंयुतः एवभ्यामस्य हरो विष्णुपदान्ते अनेको उप्स संयुतः गृहाण एतानि
प्रभुज इन अनेको युक्त असंयुतः कांट वी यूज ओरामंतानाम अनंतानाम च अव्ययानाम सर्वेश्वरे
अनेको इज नॉट अव्यय
इट्स नॉट अनेक ओके
इट इज बेसिकली अनेकः विच टर्न्स इनटू अनेको
ओके
बाय विष्णु सर्वसंग गृहाण युक्त एतानि गृहाणै तानि आदेशो युक्त अहम्
आदेशो अहम्
आदेशो हा एवभ्यामस्य हरो विष्णुपदान्ते आदेशो अहम्
द लास्ट वन पञ्चयुक्त एव सो एद्वय ऐ any questions and any sanji tulsi priya mata ji is it like okay we are getting something is it fine I mean you are understanding
I'm slower but I'm You know, I have to go over things again. I'm starting from way behind, so.
Please. So, okay, I'll give one like complete assignment for Sarveshwara Sandhi in Google Classroom. That's for the whole Sarveshwara Sandhi, including the sutras which we studied today. So, yeah, please do that for practice. And then day after tomorrow we'll start with Vishnu Jana Sandhi.
Prabhuji, can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
Prabhuji, for the 18th one, can you pull it on the screen? Yeah. So for the 18th one, Shriyai Yukta Utsukaha, somehow I use the A-I-I-I Sutra.
Okay.
And... I used
Idvayam Vibhaya Sarveshwara
Yes, Roger.
Oh yeah, I was knowing that. So this is not just E Rama, it's I. So this is in English we write it like A and I for I. So it's I, one Sarveshwar.
So ideally I should be using A I I I. So
yes. Yeah, I I.
Okay. Okay, I, yeah.
Hmm.
Okay, Roger. Okay.
Trailing on his question, that would be, it would be Irama if it were a consonant before it, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we'll resume on Thursday. Hare Bol, Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
Hey, Krishna Bo.
Hare Krishna.
Giras Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.